Morning, dear everyone. This is Sai Pranav, fourth class. Welcome to Natural Biology.
Hello, everyone. How are you all? Welcome to a beautiful platform, Natural Biology. And in the previous class, I have discussed about the life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica and life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. Now come to another topic, that is Ascaris lumbricoides, life cycle of Ascaris lumbricoides, and we are discussing the chapter 8 from NCERT, Human Health and Disease, and Telangana Intermediate First Year, Unit 6, Biology in Human Welfare. Okay, and even other state boards also the topic may be, but need point of view, definitely we have to learn about each and every point of Ascaris lumbricoides. Okay, this is the information which is given, that is enough. Okay, for the NEET level, let's, without late, we'll start the class. But before going to start, try to understand the situation and try to subscribe, support. If you are listening for the first time, give me your best support, subscribe the channel. This is only way for me, you are my strength, because there are n number of videos in the YouTube and the topic may not come to the top list. Okay, so that is why if you tell your friends, okay, if you are listening for the first time, if you like the class, you can inform to your friends to subscribe. That is only the request from my side. Okay, so without late, we will start the class. Right, come to Ascaris lumbricoides. It is one of the parasite. Okay, first, what is Ascaris? Its systematic position. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Nematoda, as Helminthes. Okay, and the class Phasmidea. Okay, phylum Nematoda and class Phasmidea. Nematoda, there are two class, A Phasmidea and Phasmidea. It comes under Phasmidea. Okay, it is an enteric parasite. Enteric parasite, enteron, digestive tract, alimentary canal. It lives in the digestive tract, mostly in small intestine. Not mostly, its place is the small intestine only. It lives in the small intestine. Hence, it is called enteric parasite. Hope it is clear. And it is a monogenetic parasite. Monogenetic parasite means its complete life cycle in a single host. The host is here man. Okay, so monogenetic parasite, and it is a dimorphic, having two forms, male and female, like sexes are separate, two forms are available. Dimorphic, pseudocoelomate. Okay, have false coelom, roundworms, commonly called roundworms. As you know, which type of coelom present in the roundworms? Pseudocoelom. They are pseudocoelomates, commonly called roundworms. Okay, and this parasite spread. Okay, spread to the new host through contaminated food and water. This point is important. Okay, the way of the spread is nothing but contamination food and water. Contamination means polluted with these worms. Okay, polluted with the worms, contaminated food and water. And infective stage is second stage, rhabditi form larva, larva of nematodes, larvae of Ascaris lumbricoides is the rhabditi form larva. Second stage rhabditi form larva is the infective stage. When we take contaminated food and water, these larvae enter into our body. Okay, at which stage? Second stage rhabditi form larva, hence it is infective stage to us. Okay, and these larvae undergo four moultings. Moulting is nothing but removing the outer layer, sheath. Okay, become active stage. So there are four moultings and four stages of larvae. First stage, second, third and fourth stage of larva is present. After fourth stage, it is going to become young one. Okay, right, let's talk about structure. How the worms will be? As we know, we can call round worms. Okay, sexes are separate, male and female. It is a male symbol and it is a female symbol. It is a male worm, it is a female worm. So sexual dimorphism, both are different forms, hence it is called sexual dimorphism. and body is elongated, long body, cylindrical body. Why we can call it round worm? If we take a transverse section, it gives a round color appearance. It is a digestive tract, alimentary canal, and it is a round body. Hence, it is called round worms. In their transverse section, for example, it is a worm. If we cut horizontally, it gives the round color appearance. Hence, it is called round worms. Hope you understand here. Body is elongated and cylindrical body. Which type of body? Cylindrical body. Right. First, we'll talk about their structure. First, we'll talk about male. Later, about female structure. Male have curved posterior end. This anterior end, it is a posterior end. Okay. This male have curved posterior end, whereas female have straight posterior end. This is one of the important difference between male and female. Okay. Male have curved posterior end, whereas female have straight posterior end. Here I written curved posterior end. In female, straight posterior end. Right. In both, anterior side mouth is present. Here, mouth is present at anterior end. Okay. This. Just below the mouth, mid ventrally. This is the dorsal region, back side. Front region, ventral region, mid ventrally, very near from the mouth, in this region a small pore opening is present. This is called excretory pore. Excretory pore means they have complete gut, mouth and excretory pore. Okay, or even anus also present in female. Complete digestive tract, complete alimentary canal is present. Mouth is present just below the mouth. Midventrally, excretory pore present in both male and female. Right. And in male, at the male, this curved posterior end is considered as a tail. Just in front of the tail, there is an opening which is called cloacal aperture. What? Cloacal aperture. Cloaca is present. Cloaca is a common opening for digestive tract and excretory. Here already excretory pore is there, na? Then reproductive opening. Digestive opening, reproductive opening is common opening, that is called cloaca. Then exterior opening is called cloacal aperture. Okay, so this is the cloacal aperture. And at cloacal aperture, there is a pair of equal sized, remember, because in Ucher area, next to unequal sized pineal set are present. Here, equal sized pineal spicules are present. Pineal spicules. They are also called as pineal setae. Pineal spicules are setae which act like a male copulatory organs which release the sperms into the female body. Okay. So this is about the structure of male. In female, from mouth, to one third of the body having one more opening midventrally, one third of the mouth midventrally, there is a female genital pore to receive the sperms, okay, or to release the eggs. Okay, female genital pore is present. And in front of the tail, little front of the tail, anus is present. In male, anus is absent, cloacal aperture is present. Whereas in female, anus is present. This is the structure of male and female. Okay, hope you understand. Now let us talk about its life history, life cycle. Okay. Through contaminated food and water, this second stage rapidity form larva enters into the intestine. It undergoes changes, it becomes adult. Now, adult worms are in intestine. Where these are present? These are present in small intestine. Where it is present? In our small intestine. Small intestine. In small intestine, they undergo copulation. Okay? Two adult male and female meet each other. Copulate each other. Reproduce. Okay, so copulation takes place in small intestine. After the copulation, Female produced 2 lakhs eggs per day. How many? 2 lakhs eggs per day. These female, after the copulation, release 2 lakhs eggs per day. This number is important. Okay? Right. So, these eggs undergo changes. Okay? And gives the larvae, rapidity form larva. Larva undergo 4 moultings. How many moultings? 4 moultings. Then after 4th molting, it becomes young one. Okay? Right. Now, female release the eggs. Okay? After producing the 2 lakhs eggs per day, some of the eggs released, some of the or most of the or all, whatever it is, depend on the situation. These eggs comes out from the body, from that man, from that human. Okay? So, here, the eggs are coming out of the body. Okay? Right. So, here it is releasing out. And these eggs are, if you talk about the structure of egg, egg is little different in shape when compared to other eggs. Because outer surface of the egg having a rippled surface, elevations and depressions are present. Not smooth surface, rippled surface. Okay. And covered with a protein coat. Outer protein coat is present. Protein coat is present, gives a rippled surface. Hence, these type of eggs are called mammillated eggs. Important 2 marks question in the IPE. Okay, mammillated eggs. What are mammillated eggs? Where do we find? In which phylum we can find? We can find in Nematoda or Selminthes. The eggs which are covered with a protein coat and which shows the rippled surface, that type of eggs are called mammillated eggs. Immediate beneath the protein coat, there is a chitinous shell is present. Chitinous shell is present. And inside the chitinous shell, there is a fat layer. Lipid layer is present. Lipid layer. These 3 layers have to remember. Because neat point of view, you may expect arrange the layers of the mammillated eggs from outer to inner, inner to outer. So here, neat point of view important. We can frame a question in these layers. Outer protein coat, inside the protein coat, what is present? Chitinous shell, and inside to chitinous shell, there is a lipid layer. And inside, cytoplasm is present, nucleus is present. So, this is called mammillated eggs. So, these eggs release out of the body. Mammillated eggs release out of the body. Okay, here I marked it already. So, mammillated eggs are coming out from the body. Through the fecal matter, when the person undergo defecation outside, okay, in the mostly villages, the person who carry the water bottle or water in a mug or jug, whatever it is, and go to outside defecation, okay, London, dairy milk, whatever it is. When they go outside defecation, through their fecal matter, these mammillated eggs release into the soil. In moist soil, inside the mammillated egg, so, this nucleus undergo changes. Okay, this total layer, the egg, it is actually the egg. It undergo changes, become larva. Okay, so inside the protein coat, our egg undergo changes, it become larval stage. This larva is called first stage rapidity form larva. Where first stage rapidity form larva is present, inside the soil, inside the egg. Okay, protein coated egg. Okay, right. Now this first stage rapidity form larva. First stage rapidity form larva undergo first molting. I already told molting means what? Removing the outer sheath, outer layer, like how snake release its skin, remove its skin. That is called molting. Ecdysis. It is also called as ecdysis. It undergo first molting, then it become an active form, that is second stage rapidity form larva. First stage rapidity form larva undergo first molting, become second stage rapidity form larva. Now this second stage rapidity form larva, okay, is the infective stage. Now it is in soil, moist soil, okay, inside the egg only, these all the changes are going on. First stage rapidity form larva is formed, it gone. First molting, then it becomes second stage rapidity form larva. Second stage rapidity form larva with protein coat is the infective stage to us. Because where it is mixed with the nearby water bodies, water is contaminated, okay, or even house flies or any cockroaches carry the such type of fecal matter from the contaminated area to the food, they contaminated to the food. So through these vectors, okay, through these vectors or contaminated water, they enter into the new host, okay. So here it is going to a new host. So hence second stage rapidity form larva is the infective stage, important in the need point of view, okay. Name the larvae of infective stage larvae of Nematoda or Selminthes or Ascaris lumbricoides, second stage rapidity form larvae, okay. Now it is enter into the new host through food and water, it goes to the stomach, intestine, okay, finally it get it settled in the small intestine. Where? In the small intestine. In small intestine, because of several enzymes, this protein coat get dissolved, comes out, larvae comes out, okay. Here shell get dissolved and in the small intestine larva is comes out, okay. Remember, when it is reached to the new host through contaminated food and water, through esophagus, stomach, it reaches to the small intestine. In small intestine, because of effect of enzymes, especially trypsin like of enzymes, okay, because of the trypsin, remember, the shell get dissolved and larvae is released. Once they released, once they become free, how they act, you know that they go to different areas. Hence here, once the larva is comes out, it undergo extra intestinal migration. It comes out from the intestine, small intestine, goes to different body parts. This is called extra intestinal migration. It first go to the liver through hepatic portal vein. Hepatic portal vein. A vein, a portal system which is present between the small intestine and liver. Okay, a vein which start with capillary and end with capillary. So such type of veins are called portal veins. So connected between the small intestine and liver, hepatic portal vein. So through hepatic portal vein, it reaches to the liver. Okay, inside the liver it feed, okay, and see everything. Okay, it is better somewhat. Then it migrate from liver to the next part. It reaches from liver to heart through postcaval vein. Postcaval vein, inferior vena cava or postcaval vein. Through postcaval vein, it reaches to the heart. Okay, from heart it goes to lungs through pulmonary artery. Okay, from heart it goes to lungs through pulmonary artery. In lungs, it settles for some time, mostly in the alveoli. It undergoes changes because I think it likes much in lungs. Okay, oxygen is available, everything is available. So that is why it gets settled for some time. In lungs, it undergoes second molting. Okay, here no molting in the liver, heart. In lungs, it undergoes second molting. It becomes third stage rapidity form larva. Even here only it undergo one more molting, third molting, then it become fourth stage rapidity form larva. Two moltings occurs in the lungs, okay, remember. Now the fourth stage rapidity form larva, from lungs, alveoli of the lungs, it goes to bronchioles to bronchi, primary bronchi, then trachea to larynx, then larynx to move, goes to the next type, pipe. Here this is the esophagus, then migrate to esophagus. From bronchi it goes to trachea to larynx to pharynx, now pharynx to esophagus to stomach to again intestine, again finally it reaches to the small intestine. Okay, in new host only we are talking, this is the intestine of new host. It goes to the small intestine. In small intestine, it undergo fourth molting. Then finally, it become young one. Okay. So, young ones are there in a new host in the small intestine. Within 8 to 10 weeks, they attain sexual maturity, they develop into adult, okay, they can reproduce after 8 to 10 weeks. Again copulation takes place in the small intestine, again they produce larvae, eggs convert into larvae, same cycle will continue. So its entire life cycle completed in only one host, hence it is monogenetic parasite. It is lives only in the small intestine, enteric parasite. Two forms are present, digenetic parasite. Hope you understand about the life cycle of Ascaris lumbricoides. Ascaris lumbricoides. Okay? Right, pathogenicity. Sir, okay, it is completing its life cycle. How do we get effect? That is called what? Pathogenicity. This Ascaris lumbricoides swarm, okay, cause ascariasis. Disease name is called ascariasis. Entamoeba histolytica cause amoebiasis. Ascaris lumbricoid cause ascariasis. Symptoms of the disease. Generally, when the worms are very less, okay, mostly children are affected here. When the worms are very less, there is asymptomatic, no symptoms are available, which cannot cause any symptoms. But a heavy infection, where the number of worms are more, in heavy infection, they cause nutritional deficiency in the children. Nutritional deficiency, our food, our glucose, vitamins, proteins, everything, it will sucked by, consumed by that worms only. Okay, cause nutritional deficiency in children. Abdominal pain, stomach pain, okay, abdominal pain. So, because of consuming our nutrients, it may cause stunted growth, reduced growth in the children. These all are symptoms in the children. So, that is why it most commonly in children. Remember, ascariasis disease symptoms, when the infection, when the larvae are less, asymptomatic, when a heavy infection causes nutritional deficiency, abdominal pain, stunted growth, okay, in the children, that's all. That is why, you know, in every school for children, for every year, once in a year, the school or nearby government hospital persons like nurse, everything, doctors will provide a special tablet, asbendazole, okay, a tablet which kills these type of worms, because it is asymptomatic, generally it is asymptomatic. So even though we have to take that tablet, okay, it is like a chewable tablet, asbendazole, okay, right. Hope you understand why the tablet is given every year in the schools, okay, to kill these type of worms. Right, prophylaxis. Prophylaxis nothing but prevention. Prevention is better than cure. Prevention, prophylaxis same like entamoeba histolytica. What are those? First, we have to use boiled and filtered drinking water. Boiled water, which may kill, the heat may kill the worms. Boiled and filtered water. Okay, first prophylaxis, and second prophylaxis, wash your hands with soap, wash the vegetables, wash the fruits, okay, so that is the second prophylaxis. And come to the last one, use septic tank toilets, not outside defecation, only use septic tank toilets, so there is no contamination of food through the fecal matter. Hope you understand about the life cycle of Ascaris lumbricoides. If you like the class, please support me, subscribe my channel, inform to your friends, you are my strength. Thank you.